the Deuce, Cole High, on Cut Sharks. And here's the host of Cut Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Jeff. I'm not going to say a word about your outfit. Don't be afraid. Welcome to Cut Sharks. Nice to have you all here, and nice to have you at home. Well, there's somebody who knows how the game is played. Call low on an ace and high on a deuce, Miss Laurie Russell of Mount Sterling, Kentucky, who watches us on WAVE-TV, Channel 3. Thank you, Laurie Russell. Now let's get to the cards. And Janice and Autumn, if you will, start loading in the cards, and we'll meet our card sharks. Jill Mattern, our champion. Hi, Jill. Good to see you again.
It's good to see you again.
Won't you again tell us something about yourself?
Yes, my name is Jill Mattern, and I still live in Rancho Cucamonga. And my husband is so excited, and my little boy just loves seeing me on TV.
And I can't imagine why your husband would be excited. Would it be the fact that you've won $9,325 in cash?
I think that helps.
Bermia Lane, our challenger. Hi, Bermia.
Hi, Jim.
Good to see you again, and won't you again tell us something about yourself?
Okay, my name's Bermia Lane. I'm an accounting clerk for an insurance company. I model also part-time. And I'm happy to be here again.
Good. We're delighted to have you back. And, of course, you got game number one, so you've got a leg up on a crack of those money cards. Now, you both cut the cards, yes?
Yes,
before you started the match, then we'll pick up where we left off. We play the best two games out of three. And as I say, Bermia won game number one at $100. And we're about to start game number two. And now the champion needs this to stay in the match. Bermia, we left off. The question goes to you. Bermia, we found one. Oh, this is my favorite all-time poll. And we have yet another question. We found 100 married men who have a pig as a pet. And we asked them, who weighs more, your pig or your wife?
Oh, my.
How many men said the wife weighs more than their pig?
Well, I don't think very many men would like to say so. But I'm sure they'll have to if they're going to be honest. So I'd say it would be a low number. Let's see. 55.
That low, huh? 55 out of 100 say that the wife weighs more than the pig. Jill, higher or lower?
I think it's going to be lower, quite a bit lower.
Lower than that?
Yeah.
Well, if it's lower, you'll play your cards. If not, Bermia will play hers. The actual number of men whose wife weighs more than their pig is 25. It's lower, Jill. But 25? My goodness. Jill, you start with a king.
Good card. I'm going to keep the king. Please.
Lower than a king, a two.
Oh, right, higher.
Higher than a two, a seven.
Three.
And as we move over the freeze bar, protecting that position, Jill needs two cards to tie it up. Jill, this question to you. Jill, we asked 100 psychiatrists. Generally speaking, who has more trouble getting over a love affair, a man or a woman? How many psychiatrists said a woman has more trouble getting over a love affair?
I think that's going to be relatively high because women are very emotional, usually, more so than men. So I'm going to say about 64.
Jill says 64 out of 100 women have more trouble getting over a love affair, or the psychiatrists think that.
Well, I'm going to have to agree with Jill. I think that women are more emotional. They really get into it, and it's hard to get out of it. So I'm going to say it's higher.
Even higher than that?
Higher.
The actual number of psychiatrists who said a woman has more trouble getting over an affair is 71. Bernie is right. It is higher. Now we'll take a look at the challengers, a base card, a seven.
Oh, can I change that card, please?
Winning the question, you can change the base card.
Queen. Oh, it's going to be lower.
Lower than a queen. Yes, a 10.
Lower.
Risking it lower. No. Took a chance that did not pay off, and that gives Jill a free chance to play off the seven and call this.
Higher, please.
Higher than
higher.
A seven. Yes, a king.
Lower,
lower to tie up the match. She did it. She got a tie. Each player with one game and $100. And now we'll set up for the tiebreaker with three cards up there and three questions here. And in the tiebreaker, Bermia, the question to you. Now, Bermia, we asked 100 married men. The last time you tried to take a shower, were your wife's wet nylons in your way? How many married men said the last time the nylons were in the way?
Well, not only does my father have that problem with my mom's nylons, but with mine also. So I'm going to say that it's higher. It's going to be around 60.
60 out of 100 men, the last time they took a shower, the nylons were in the way.
I don't think so, because I throw mine in the washer and then in the dryer and then take them out. So I think it's going to be lower.
Lower than that?
Yeah.
The actual number of married men whose wife's wet nylons got in the way is 6. Very much lower. Jill, Yeah, we did say the last time, and that was a key in there, and Jill paid off with a 9.
Change it, please.
Big change with only 3 cards. An 8.
All right, please, lower
than an 8, the 9.
Higher.
Going against the odds.
Higher.
Is she right for a crack at the money card? Yes, she is. Oh, Jill's instincts were great there. Bermia, how can you beat instincts like that? Thank you. And you've got $100 in cash. It's a nice party gift. Thanks for being here. Good luck with your study.
Thank you.
Bermia Lane. And Jill, come on down here with me. And once again, Jill gets a crack at the money cards to add to her total, I hope, right after this commercial break. Congratulations again. And Jill Mattern, another $200 richer. You cut the money cards?
I did.
They feel good, I hope?
They feel great.
Let's keep up the good work. Come on, Jill, let's get to the money cards. Once again, $200 of new money as we give you 3 cards on the bottom line to bet as you will. When you move up to the second level, we'll add another $200 of betting money. 3 more cards. Your minimum bet's, of course, $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet. There you must risk at least half the money. Good luck, Joe. You're doing well. Here's $200. And you can change the base card in each of the 3 levels if you need to. And Autumn will start her off with $200. And a jack.
I'd like to change it, please. I don't
want... You must play this one. The next card off the top of the deck is... $200, all of
please.
It, but this card is lower than an 8. Yes.
Yes. $100 higher than a 6.
$100 higher than a 6. Yes, again.
Right. $500. $500 lower.
All of it.
Yes.
Big bet. Ooh, I hope she's right. $500 lower than a queen. Yeah.
Right. Woo.
And a great card. Woo. We're going to move it up. Give me the other $200. Jill, you've got $1,200 and a 2. Trying for $2,400 higher than a 2. And 8 again.
Oh, oh, all of it lower.
For $4,800 lower. Yeah. And still a great card.
Oh, oh, oh. $2,000 lower.
$2,000 lower than a queen. And, but, boy, you held back, and you still have great betting money, and a great card moves up. $2,800 and a king.
All of it. Lower, please.
Double or nothing, please, she says,
please,
and I want it to for $5,600 lower. Oh, no. Look at all those high cards. That is incredible.
I know where all the little ones went to.
Oh, there were no, that deuce is about the only low one in there. But Jill, that's the first time the cards have failed you, and you still have the $200 in the game. You are still up to $9,525. You might get a chance to do it again. We'll find out right after this. This is dealing out 2 brand new decks of cards. It's time to meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Doug Bedard. Hello, Doug. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Won't you tell us a little something about yourself, sir?
I was born in what used to be the little whaling village of New Bedford, Massachusetts. I'm currently living in the fiercely independent suburb of Boston called Brookline while I attend Boston University School of Law. I have 1 more year there. I'm currently in L.A. working for a law firm for the summer, and then I'm moving to California, and this time next year I'll be taking the California bar exam.
Good. Oh. Well, that's got to be tough, the bar exam. What are the odds on passing the bar exam the first time?
California and New York are the 2 toughest states. I think last year it went down to like 75%.
Well, we wish you well with that, and we wish you well here. You cut your cards?
Yes, I did.
And here we go. We start the best 2 out of 3 with a question to the champion. Jill, now, got a picture for you. Let me get this up here. Now, I want you to take a look at this picture. Now, our man on the street stopped 100 people at the corner of Hollywood and Vine in Los Angeles and asked them, who is this man? How many of those people knew that this is, of course, Johnny Carson?
I think...
How many?
Everybody knows Johnny Carson. You, at one time or another, you've stayed up late and have to
Hollywood
watch...
Hollywood and Vine now.
Well, that's true, too. That is true. Okay, but I still think it's going to be a relatively high number, and I'm going to say 78.
78?
Yeah.
78 out of 100. I don't know the answer. I did not... I hope I was not leading you in
no,
any way there.
Not at all.
She says 78. Doug, higher or lower?
Well,
Johnny Carson.
Especially with the controversy that's been going around as to whether or not he's going to stay. He's not just been on at 11 o'clock, 11:30 at night, rather. He's been on the news at prime time. It's got to be even higher than that.
Higher than that?
Yes.
Well, The actual number of people who knew that this is a picture of Johnny Carson is 85. It is higher, Doug. 85. So John will be so pleased to hear that. And Doug, you start the match with a king.
Beautiful card. Keep that card lower.
Lower than the king.
Oh, no.
Same thing that happened to Jill, only this time she's happy about the double king. She gets a free chance at a queen.
Take queen lower.
Lower than a queen. A five.
Higher.
Risking it higher. It is a
please.
10. And Jill comes out of that exchange with a two-card advantage. Question to you, Doug. Doug, we asked 100 people. Do you think prison inmates should be allowed to have overnight visits from their wives? How many people think that prisoners should be allowed to have overnight visits from their wives?
Trying not to speak as an almost attorney and speak as an average person, there's much more sensitivity nowadays to whether or not punishment is cruel and unusual. There's a lot of talk about the condition of the prisons today. I think people are concerned with making conditions more humane, even though they know those people who are in the prisons are there for a reason. So I'd say that have to be a fairly high number, about 65.
65 out of 100 say yes, they should be allowed
I'm
to have visits.
I'm sorry for the poor guys. I'd like to think high, but I think it's lower.
You think
yeah.
lower at all. The actual number of people who think prisoners should be allowed to have overnight visits from their wives is 51. Jill is right. It is lower. And Jill with a 10.
Could I change it, please?
Now you can get rid of it, winning the question. A 7.
Okay, I'm going to take the 7 and go higher, please.
Higher than a 7? Oh, no, another 7. And this time, Doug with a free chance to play off the king.
The king is going higher.
Higher than the king?
Yes. Oh, what am I doing?
You can go higher if you like.
Oh, no, I'm not as crazy as I look. The king's going lower.
Lower than a king. It is a 6.
With that king, that's a good base card. I'm going to keep going higher than that 6.
Higher than the 6. He's right with a jack.
Jack is a good one. Keep going lower.
Lower than a jack. A 3.
3, no question in my mind. Higher.
For the first game of the match, is he right? Yes. Woo! Oh, that wins it. Game one to the challenger in $100. And now we will set up for game number 2 with the same two decks of cards as Janice deals out the top cards, next cards off the top of the deck. Jill, the pressure's on you now. You need to make a comeback. Jill, now there are good girls and there are bad girls. So we asked 100 bachelors, have you ever asked a girl out only because you heard she was a bad girl? How many bachelors have asked a girl out because she was supposed to be a bad girl?
Definitely. They want to get a little, and if they can't from the good girls, they're going to go to the bad ones. I'm going to say that's high. 80.
80?
Yes.
80 out of 100, Doug. What do you
think? Oh, I know I've considered it several times. But bad girls tend to be expensive, too. So I say that has to be lower.
Lower. I've got a sorry ask this question. The actual number of bachelors who've asked a girl out because she was supposed to be a bad girl is 41. Doug, you're right. It's lower. For whatever the reason, it's lower. And Doug starts with a 3.
3, beautiful. Higher.
Higher than a 3, an 8.
Ooh, a little weird. I'm going to freeze on that card.
We move over the freeze bar, and the question goes to you, Doug. Doug has adjectives for everything. The wonderful old whaling company. Doug, we asked 100 child psychiatrists. Generally speaking, if a small child has a nightmare, should his parents let him into bed with them? How many child psychiatrists said, yes, the parents should let him into bed with them?
Oh, my psychology professor would kill me if I blew this one. But I honestly don't remember what happened in the course. I would say that would be a very bad thing to do because psychiatrists would think it increases dependency. It's got to be a low number, 40.
Doug says 40 say that the parents should let him into bed with them.
I agree with Doug. I think it's low, but I don't think it's a good idea. I think it's going to be even lower.
Even lower than that.
Psychiatrist, yeah.
The actual number of child psychiatrists who said parents should let their child into bed with them is 37.
Okay.
It is lower, Jill. Doug, you almost remembered what your professor said. Jill gets it. And an 8.
All right, with the 8 lower.
Lower than an 8. A 3.
Higher, please.
Higher than a 3. A 4.
Higher again.
Higher than a 4. A jack.
Lower.
Trying to go all the way to tie it up. No. On the last card, she couldn't do it. And Doug, a big chance with an 8. Call this.
Play my feelings with that 8 higher.
Higher than the 8? Yes, a queen.
Beautiful. Queen lower.
Lower than a queen, a 9.
9? I'm going to freeze it.
And as we move over the freeze bar, Doug needs one card for the championship. And this question goes to you, Jill. Jill, now we all know that feminists object to being treated as sex objects. So we asked 100 feminists, if a really ugly-looking policeman said he would not give you a speeding ticket if you'd only give him a big kiss, would you do it? How many feminists said, yeah, they'd kiss the cop?
Even though they're feminists, not to get a ticket is good. I'm going to say it's about 64.
64 out of 100 would kiss the cop.
I disagree. Pride has a lot to do with being a feminist, and I really disagree that they would kiss the cop. It's got to be lower.
Lower than that. The actual number of feminists who would kiss an ugly policeman to avoid getting a speeding ticket is 12. Doug is exactly right. It is lower. Doug, you've got a 9.
With Jill with 4 cards up there, I'm going to change that 9.
You can change it. And the 9 becomes a queen.
Beautiful. No doubt in my mind, lower.
Lower than a queen. We have a new champion if it is, and we do. Jill, leaving us with $9,525. You've done very well.
It's been so much fun, and thank you again.
Thank you.
It.
Jill Mattern. Thank you, Jill. Doug, come on down here with me. Congratulations.
Thank you, Tim.
And we'll be back with our new champion right after this commercial break.
Welcome to Jill.
New champion and Doug, again, our congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, the money cards have been dealt out in front of our studio audience. Mm-hmm. You know how to play them, of course.
That's right.
Good luck. Here's $200.
Thanks.
And remember that you can change those base cards on each of the 3 levels. That's often a help. Doug, you'll start off with $200 and a 2.
A 2. No doubt. Oh, $200 higher.
All of it $200 higher than a 2.
No.
A double ace and a couple times, too.
I'm not too disheartened.
All right, you're not out of it, though. We've got the other $200 of betting money. It is still a great card. We move it up. You're back in it. 4 cards to go.
Same
Come
thing.
On.
All of it higher.
Let's not do it again. Double it. Come on. Higher than a 2. Yeah, with a jack.
Beautiful. Jack, it's your money, not mine. All of it lower.
All of it on a jack?
Yes.
Oh, is he right? 400 big dollars lower than a jack? No! I thought that was a big bet. There were no other face cards showing. Well, as you said, it's our money, not yours.
True.
But, of course, it would have been yours if you had won it, Doug, which wouldn't have been too bad. So come on down here with me. You still have the $200 in the game, and maybe Doug will get a crack at doing it again. He's a good player. We'll be back with our champion right after this commercial break.
In a world.
Now Janice is dealing out 2 brand new decks of cards now. We'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. KJ Goodwin. Hello, KJ. Nice to have you here.
Great. Great to be here.
Why don't you tell us a little about yourself?
My name is Karen Jo Goodwin. You can call me KJ, though.
Okay.
I'm a student at UCLA. I'm studying voice. I'm also a secretary, and this summer I'm counseling Japanese foreign exchange students.
Oh, that's terrific. Do you speak Japanese?
No. But we do a lot of sign language.
Okay. Good luck. We're happy to have you here
Thank
with us.
Thank you. It's
you
great.
Cut your cards?
Yes, I
and
did.
And here we go. We'll start the best 2 out of 3 with a question to Doug. And Doug, now everyone is talking about waste and economizing all the time, so we went right to the source. We asked 100 garbage men, do you think Americans waste too much? How many garbage men said, yes, Americans waste too much?
Garbage men have both their own perceptions and the perceptions of them as consumers and the perception of them as garbage men. I would say that's a fairly high number, 75.
75 out of 100 garbage men said, yes, we waste too much.
Well, I think they do know a lot about, because they see all the garbage and everything. But I know that the United States people are kind of wasteful type people. At least that's what they all say. So I'd say it's a higher number. Let's go higher.
Even higher than that?
Yes, yes.
The actual number of garbage men who think Americans waste too much is 81. KK is right. It is higher. Well, we got the expert opinion, and it's 81 out of 100. KJ, with an 8.
Oh, change that card, please.
Winning the question, getting rid of it.
Oh.
And a little better.
Let's go lower, lower.
Lower than the 10, a 6.
Oh. Let's freeze.
And we move over the freeze bar, protecting that position. And that's about all the time we have for now. So, KJ, we got you started. You've got a little bit of a lead. Does that make you feel better?
Great.
Incidentally, now you're studying voice. What do you intend to do?
I want to be a pop singer.
Oh, pop singer.
Yeah.
We wish you well with that.
Thank
you. Love to hear you sing something. You're a very pretty lady.
Thank you.
And this pretty lady and our nice gentleman here who's going to be a lawyer will be back with us on our next Card Sharks. And I do hope you'll be back with us as well. Thank you so much, my friends. Have yourself a good day. Bye-bye.
High.
One mistake and Chris retains the championship.
So it pays to go slow.
Freeze right there.
play your cards right,
I'll try it higher,
and you might win the show.
Lower than the queen.
Yes! Yeah!
On Card Sharks, wild game, witty poetry. Next on Game Show Network.
Rodman Productions.